Hey guys, K-Parts for PCs here, and today, got another free computer. Yes, another one. It's strange how these things happen. Now, this is a Dell Optiplex, whatever, because this is that old to where I don't think they have any markings on it. Especially any side that I would preferably want to show you, including the top, because of some information on there that could disclose my location. But yes, that is, this is just old Dell Optiplex with all I really know is a Core 2 Duo, which, I mean, we could probably upgrade this to a Core 2 Quad for like 10 bucks and, I don't know, throw in a cheap GPU. I have some videos coming out with GPUs that you can probably get either for free. One of them I got completely for free. And then another one. I mean, you can get it for 20 bucks or less on eBay. US listings, obviously. Well, I gotta get this thing open first to check what's in here. Hopefully it's not complete garbage like a 5400 RPM hard drive or something stupid like that. I don't know. Well, see whenever I open this. Okay, now I have this thing open. I have this bad boy open. First of all, the first thing I notice is this cable running atop, across this hard drive. Now, this hard drive. What is it? It's a Seagate, thankfully. Let me get this lined up. Yeah, it's a Seagate. Oh, my lens is on the other side, yeah. And, yeah, that's all I know about it. Maybe it's, like, really big, like 500 gigs or something. I have a feeling that it is not. So, looking through this, seems to be 7200 RPM. Nice. Oh my. Found this little box at the bottom right here. 80 gigabytes. How in God's name would the school district get away with 80 gigs of hard drive space? Or even whenever this was decommissioned. Oh, a bit of context. This got decommissioned through a school, and I basically got it for free because they said, we either throw it away or a random kid gets it. So, I'm the lucky kid. Next thing up on notice is the RAM. Now, first to get to the RAM on these old Optiplexes, you gotta pull up on the hard drive. Not hard drive, the drive and then pull so oh, and it's getting caught like they would usually do. You just kind of hope it eventually comes out, and it does. And yeah, now we have this open, and if I wanted to put an expansion card down here right there, I could. Now, what that would be, a good question. No clue. Now time to see if this is DDR2 or DDR3. Hopefully DDR3. Come on, give me 8 gigs of DDR3. Well, it seems that... Oh, it's DDR2. 800 megahertz, but this is a 2 gig stick. So if this is 2 gigs, and if they're using all the same sticks, this theoretically has... This whole entire system has 8 gigs and quad channel memory, which, a bit strange. Even now, running quad channel memory in a standard desktop. Now, only reason why I can see this being a case is that the school district I got this from, wanting to extend its life a bit longer past its, you know, shelf life, which, the shelf life of the CPU in here in the DDR2 alone ended many, many years ago. Many, many moons, you could say. But we must carry on now. So after I put this back in, is it right? Yeah, that's right. Oh my god. Yep. Boom, now we got it back in. Next thing of measure, actually, I don't have taken these types apart before. The only way to unscrew them is to have a needle nose screwdriver. And it is a shame that I do not have a needle nose. So, other than that, what else do we have in this computer that, you know, was free? Well, let's check back the rear I.O. So, first up on the rear I.O. tour, we got a parallel port, I think, either that or serial. I think it's parallel because it has the printer image. That is old. This is old. We have three dinosaur ports back here. We got VGA. I mean, I can still use that. And then we got serial, RJ9, I think. Yeah, it's RJ9, then printer. Then we got, you know, display port, so I can still use this on a mod, like, integrated graphics. I can still use on a modern monitor. But next major thing is eSATA. Ugh, eSATA. I haven't even ever used one of those ports before. Those are practically dead, even during, you know, 2009 or whenever this came out. Then we got a respectable six back USB ports with two combo jack for, I think that's microphone. And, no, yeah, for microphone and headphones. And then this is speaker. And then, of course, we got Ethernet, probably, hopefully gigabit. But the real main question is, how good is this power supply? Now, this power supply, obviously, is the Dell Special garbage, like usual, but seeing as it's not too hard to find the power, the wattage on here, I think it's, it says 235, okay. So this should be enough to run at least a discrete GPU in here, which, like a low power one. So, I'm going to get this all set back up together and maybe even throw in a GPU and see what happens. And yeah, I may change out the hard drive because, well, I don't want to spend forever waiting for this 80 gig hard drive with a like 16 gig partition just to boot. So yeah, be back in a bit whenever I have this all done up. Well, everyone, we are booting. Whoa, look at that. 1024 by 768, 30 hertz. I'm really maxing out that display port down there with this meek little display adapter thing I have for display port to HDMI. But still, it's booting into Windows. And which Windows that is, that's a good question. Because I have no clue. I think it may be Windows 8, Windows 10. I don't know, but I have a feeling this will be a while. Because, as you can hear, the furiously writing and reading from the hard drive begins. Oh yeah, I decided to keep the same one in there just for time's sake. Oh my god, it's up. Okay, well, it's time for me to grab out the illustrious fake gamer keyboard and mice that I've been using. Yes, this Game DS crap that I've gotten from some pre-built computer that I got Facebook. Oh, well, I guess on the front it says Optiplex 760, so I should have looked at that before saying that I don't know. Okay, well, I got a mouse. Got a mouse now. And a keyboard. Now, hopefully this doesn't have proprietary school software, and if it does, I'm going to be kind of mad because, well, it's school software. And I can't really do much with that. Other than probably take the hard drive out of this one, put it in a different desktop, and then do something like get rid of all the files of the school. And yep, there. How do I sign into other domain? Okay, well, I think I'm gonna have to put the camera down now because, you see what this is, you may know where this is at, and I'd much rather not get doxxed. So yes, I will resume recording soon. Well, everyone, I am back, and now I get to do the fun, arduous task after I've tried entering in multiple ways to get into, like, past the domain on here, since, of course, it was, like, a school-type computer. So, I have to reset this completely, and that can take several hours. So, can't wait to have this sitting here making this little buzzing thing all night. It's going to be great. Just a little bit sarcastic, but hey, can't tell. So, I'm going to reset this, maybe put this on a time lapse, or do another video. Anyways, guys, this is going to take forever for me, but it won't take forever for you guys. So this is like a 5-minute video, so yeah, just all right, just okay. Well, okay, guys, about 12 hours later, after turning on my TV, I wake up to this. The restart was successful. And now, basically, I'm just going to run through it and probably show you how to start Windows or something. Basically, just going to go through here. US, obviously. By my accent, I guess. US. Skip. We may have Windows up and running. Oh, great. It's asking for networking. Okay. So, I'm not hooking this up to Ethernet right now. I don't have internet. Except. Name. Ooh. What should I name this? Let's name it user. All caps. And password? It's also a good question. What should I name it? Not what should I name it, but what should I make it? I think I'm just gonna make it what's written on the side of the side panel over there. Have it next to where I'm sleeping, and yeah. I'm just gonna make it that, because that makes it to where whoever I sell this to will most likely just look at the side of your their computer and just see something written out in Sharpie, like, 5 years ago or something. Oh, great. Security questions. Fantastic. Just in case you... Oh, great. I'm just gonna save this one, and yeah, the fun, arduous task of making Windows just work. Well, think that should be it. And no, Cortana sucks. Nobody ever uses Cortana, and if you do, I feel bad for you. Well, I think that Windows 10 setup on a Dell Optiplex 760 that's been reinstalling all night. Fantastic, you know? I love it whenever I wake up with a blue screen destroying my retinas. Oh my god. Practical dust storm out there today. Sorry. Just looking at my surroundings outside. Here's where the terrible part of his hard drive comes into play. It taking forever to read up. Yep, there we go. But it will take several minutes. As per expected. Well, I'm just going to stop recording here and then start recording whenever I pick back up. Oh, and I may slap a GPU inside this thing. Just to have a better display out because, yeah, what I have right now is not the best. So, yeah. Well, now I'm back. And it seems like we have one of the freshest installs of Windows I have ever seen. It doesn't even have Internet Explorer out there next to the recycling bin, as it's still down in the taskbar. It doesn't have anything. It must be an older version of Windows 10, but hey. So now let's see if my guesses were right for this old computer. Let's see if my guesses were right. Oh, I don't like that. Oh, thank God. Okay, so thankfully this is not at 100% because that would be scary. Okay, so this is a Core 2 Duo E8400 clocked at 3 gigahertz or 2.99, but basically 3 gigahertz. This is basically just a modern day Celeron. Like, this is literally just a modern day Celeron. Just a modern day Celeron. No hyper threading, 2 cores. And yeah, I mean, but seeing as the newest Celerons cost like $50 and this whole entire computer together costs zero, I think this would be a better deal. So, of course, we have 8 gigs of RAM. Thankfully, we have 6 gigs available right now. And it's at 800 megahertz. All four slots, obviously, are, you know, filled, as you can tell. And our disk. Hopefully, this is not 80 gigs. I will be disappointed if this is, like, actually 80 gigs. Oh, no, not even 80 gigs. 74 gigs. Okay, so that's not even enough to hold, like, 2 games. Not even 1, actually. As you all know, COD Warzone takes up more than 100 gigs. So, yeah, that's great. But, well, now I have a brand new desktop ready to resell. And I'm probably going to put a, like, Core 2 Quad in here, resell that. Hey, make sure to watch another video soon that I'm about to post. It's about how to uninstall and reinstall CPUs. I got a new one, and it's going to be great. Anyways, guys, this is KParser PCs signing out.